here at Kiel Golf Centre with TG Test Pro Neil Wayne, and we are talking the TaylorMade new BRNR Mini Driver. Where do we start, Neil? Because this is like a nostalgic retake on a classic.
It does look like a classic, does it? Especially that little old school logo that you've got just on the outskirts of the Terrier. I really like the look of it, to be fair.
Okay, so in this video, we are going to try and show you about where this club would sit in a player's bag. And we're going to do that by getting Neil to hit his own driver, a Fairway-Wood, and then we're going to compare that against the BRNR Mini Driver. So both from a tee and from the turf. Mm. But let's get started first. Let's have a look at what you actually need to know about them.
Yeah, so I think this is for the golfer that's going to struggle from the tee. Mm-hmm. If you are somebody who hitting driver puts the frighteners up you, and you feel like you don't get enough out of the fairway wood from the tee, the mini driver would fall perfectly into this. Okay. It's more about accuracy from the tee.
Okay, so TaylorMade say that a number of their players at the Masters were toying around with this head because for a very, very tight golf course, you have to put a premium out on tour on hitting the fairway, on being in play. None of them actually put it in play during the Masters, but it's highly likely at some point during the season when they come to play another very, very tight course that they might well look at these again.
Yeah.
What else, Neil?
So you've got the multi-material construction, obviously carbon crown, titanium face with steel construction. Mm-hmm. Got the K-shaped sole with movable weight in there, Simon. So if you are somebody who wants to get a little bit more forgiveness and increase the MOI, get the heavier weight more towards the back, or if you're looking for a little bit less spin, lower launch, a little bit more ball speed, get that heavier weight forward. This one here we've got actually has got 13 grams weight and a 1.57. We've got it set where the 13 grams is a little bit back weighted at the minute.
Okay, and if you're a decent player, it will be music to your ears. What TaylorMade are saying is that you can get sort of distance-like driver off the deck, which tends to be a long distance with plenty of run out, but with the consistency of using a high lofted fairway wood.
Which
sounds pretty good to me.
Yeah, that's good, yeah.
Then also you've got your standard sort of TaylorMade tech, so the twist face and then the through slot, speed slot in the sole of the club to protect ball speed for when you hit shots low on the face.
And it's worth mentioning there, Simon, as well, obviously the two loft options. You've got your 11.5 and your 13.5.
Okay, and whilst we're on about specs, let's just talk shaft. So it's a retro Pro 465, which back in the day was a really good
US team, man, you've made phenomenal shafts always, haven't they? Yeah, but like you say, retro. Only available in stiff and regular, though, so if you're the X or the A Flex, you're not quite, it's not quite suited for you, this one.
Brilliant. Okay, well, let's get out there and then we'll see you back here where we'll talk you through how these clubs differ. Just before we speak data, let's start by trying to give some feedback on how we feel it was hitting it from both the tee and then from the turf, Neil.
Yeah, so I think it's quite, it's a pleasing golf club from a tee, personally. Obviously, with it being like a mini driver look, it does look bigger and a deeper profile than a normal fairway would. Therefore, from the ground, I found that it was a little bit intimidating to look at at address thinking, crikey, this is going to be difficult to launch. I'm going to have to really get at this to get some speed, to get generate some spin, to get the thing to, in the air. Fairway wood from the deck isn't a shot that I like anyway, so to put that in my hands even made me feel even more uncomfortable. But from a tee, it was a lot easier, really.
Okay, and just give us a little bit of feedback around the ball flight, because I've seen you hit the fairway woods a number of times, and you get it up there. It's a great flight, with this it's much lower, driving it forward.
I felt like it
lots of runouts.
Yeah, it was more of a real lower penetrating flight, quite hot off the face. Didn't feel like I was losing any ball speed, but if you were somebody who plays links golf or you're looking for that lower ball flight at windy conditions, you're looking for maximum run if you've got them firmer fairways, then yeah, great. But I do feel like for me from the deck especially, it would be a one trick pony. This has got to go into a par five with a steep descent angle and a good peak height, it'd have to be a fairway wood, Simon. But then again, on the flip side, from the tee, if you said hit me a little bit of a fairway finder, then yeah, that'd be a good option. Yeah.
Okay, so just worth noting as well, the last sort of major player that we saw using a mini driver was Phil Mickelson at the PGA Championship. a Kiwa Island. Yeah. So somewhere where you can run it out, somewhere that you can, you know, sort of hit that low ball.
For certain conditions, it's got its place, hasn't it? There's a market for it, definitely.
Okay. So let's have a look at data. You said something which I absolutely love. This club is not aimed at me.
No, because
you love
my driver. Well, yeah, I love my driver. It's probably my favourite club in the bag. I'd probably rather get a driver from the tee than any fairway would. Mm-hmm. So it's not really aimed at me. Golfers would be looking at this thinking, crikey, he's 22 yards down on his own driver, and there isn't really much difference in the shot area. Yeah, but that's for me. Like I've just said, I'd like to consider myself a good driver of the golf ball.
Yeah.
For the golfer say if I was to put that in a 2,650 square yard area, and then I reduced it to 750, happy days, because I'm in play more now with the mini driver from the tee. Okay. That's what it's about. It's about getting that accuracy. You're not going to hit this further than your driver, because you won't. Mm-hmm. It's physics, isn't it, at the end of the day?
Just worthwhile pointing out as well that we've used the high loft, so the 13.5.
Yeah.
So you would expect a little bit of difference between that and your own driver.
Yeah, yeah.
And I know that we've said it doesn't suit you, it's not aimed at you, but no. I know somebody that hates hitting driver.
Yeah.
They always use a driving iron, just drive it out there as far as they possibly can do with that, you know, and then go from there. This could be right up their street.
Definitely.
So there is a market there. It might be a niche market, but there's definitely a market there for it.
Definitely.
So that's from the tee. What about from the fairway?
Yeah, so from the fairway, I feel like for me personally, it'd be really, really hard work. Conditions would have to be perfect. It'd have to be nice lie, and don't think you're going to be whipping these from the semi-rough and things like that. If you're going to use it more from the fairway, I would definitely suggest go down the weaker lofted route, a little bit more back weight, get the air out, try and get that golf ball up in the air. But it was just intimidating, small head, deep face. When it's on the ground, it just doesn't look easy to hit, really.
Okay. So, essentially, we're saying that if you don't like driver or you struggle with accuracy, then this could be a good thing.
Yeah.
If you love driver or you don't have an issue with hitting fairway woods...
Yeah, it's not really for you then, definitely. If you want something where you can do both, where you hit it from the deck and you want to hit more consistency from the tee, just get this, but get a little bit more loft would be my advice.
Right, loads of information there. We hope that we've been able to help you make a choice as to whether the mini driver would suit your game or not. If you've got any comments or questions, leave them below. We promise to answer every single sensible one. We'll see you next time.